Grand company seals. Why are they important? What are they used for? How do I get a lot of them easily? I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide on how to go about getting these, and this is perfect for new players as you'll want to do this early to help jumpstart a few different things in the game. These include selling items for gil, getting ventures for your retainers, and more, which we'll talk about near the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. Hello everyone, my name is Stefan Ash and I have another Final Fantasy guide for you. We will be talking about why Grand Company seals are so important and exactly how to farm these little bad boys really easily. It will take a little tiny bit work up front, but you'll want to do this as soon as you can and able to get the most payout later. If you get any value out of this video, then go ahead and limit break through that subscribe button down below and let's jump into the video. Grand Company seals are unlocked when you get far enough in the story to unlock Grand Company. As this is a main quest that unlocks, you cannot miss it. It will be one of your level 20 main story quests, the company you keep. It does not matter which Grand Company you choose, as you can always switch later. Once you unlock your Grand Company, you'll want to rank up, which you do by turning in Grand Company seals. I will not be going over the Grand Company as a whole, but just how to farm the GC seals or Grand Company seals. I will make a different video for understanding the squadron and Grand Company and why it's important. I will go over step on step on how to do this part, so let's focus in on it. This is our outline. I will be showing this from the Twin Adder or Gridania's perspective, but it's the same no matter which one you picked. We are shooting for 5 promotions here. That will unlock our prize, which will be an easy method to farm GCs. You should be able to unlock these in one go, which for me personally, I do recommend. I don't like doing something and then coming back to it. If I can get it all done in one go, I prefer that way. It will take you a few hours, but it is so worth it. First, we get the recruit status after the completion of level 20 main story quest, Woods will be done. After this, you're gonna start needing seals in order to upgrade. The first upgrade or rank or promotion is gonna need 2,000 seals. When you start the Grand Company, you're going to unlock the hunting log. With your newly unlocked hunting log, you'll want to do this first. You're going to kill a few enemies in the hunting log, and when you kill 3, then you're going to get seals as your prize. Once you complete rank 1, the prize for that is about 1,000 seals or so. The reason I recommend doing this first is that we're going to have to complete rank 1 for one of the promotions later, so you might as well get it out of the way now. You will have had to gone far enough in the story to have access to these other places or know where you're going. You can always look things up or where the enemies are located. It doesn't really give you the specific, but more the general location. But once you complete the hunting log, you may ask, well, how do I go about getting GCs now? Because I completed the hunting log and there's really no other way I know of. Well, one of the ways is fates. Fates are like public events out in the world. I am not a fan of this method because if you're doing the fates by yourself, you could not complete them or you might need a little help and you'd have to rely on other people in the outer world to come and help you. The second method is the method that I actually recommend and I think it's the fastest and the funnest, and that's leveling roulette. Not only do you learn dungeons by replaying them, and you'll be replaying dungeons a lot, but you're guaranteed seals at the end of your dungeon. If you're a tank or a healer, congratulations, you're gonna probably get bonus seals for being the adventurer in need for the leveling roulette. Rocking a DPS? Well, it's still actually kind of worth it. If you queue for the leveling roulette, then you can do main story quests while you're waiting for your queues to pop, killing 2 birds with 1 stone. If you've been watching any of my videos for longer than a week, then you'll know that I really like to be as helpful and efficient as possible, and always trying to double down on tasks. With the leveling roulette method, it was pretty quick in about a few hours if I just focused on it. It probably took about 10 or so leveling roulettes, sometimes quicker. If I had a tank or a healer, it took even less time. When you're going through your leveling roulette, and this is super important, you want to roll on all of your gear. Well, any dungeon you do, you always want to roll on your gear, greed or need. Need means that that particular gear is for your class. Greed means that it's not for your class, but you are able to roll on it if anyone else doesn't want it. Always need or greed. The only time you should pass if you already have it and the game won't let you roll on it at all. Now that we got our GCs and we've been leveling up, 4 ranks in, you'll need to complete the rank 1 hunting log and then turn in a certain amount of seals. After that, you'll keep turning in seals as needed until you reach Second Sergeant, which then, congratulations, you made it. Now you've unlocked Expert Deliveries. This is the absolute best and easiest, most passive way to get GC seals in the game. Once unlocked, you can turn in all of your dungeon gear that you've received and will receive from doing all your relets or main story dungeons for Grand Company seals. At lower levels, it might not seem worth it as the gear is only going to give you 78 to maybe 200 Grand Company seals per piece, but as you get later and later in the dungeons, the gear will start going up to like 500, 700, 900, with some of the endgame gear giving you 1800 seals per piece of gear. Let's talk about why we want to do this early on. GC seals can be turned in for all sorts of things and items from the attendant here. You get ventures for your retainers, which is super imperative to leveling up your retainers early on. Some other things you can get down the road are glamour prisms and cordials. These are for the glamour system in order for you to glamour things. And cordials are for gathering classes, which allows you to restore some GP fairly quickly while you're out gathering. Not only that, you can sell these specific items for money early on. Everyone always needs glamour prisms and cordials, and you'll max out on GC seals pretty regularly if you are rolling on dungeon loot frequently. There are also really cool things that you can get like barding or armor for your chocobo mount, experience boosting manuals for your crafting and gathering classes, and furniture and things for your potential future house. I make so much money passively by just turning in my loot for GCs at the end of the game and selling cordials or getting ventures and selling the special items that they bring back from their venture. There's also some really cool emotes and other things you can get. I'm gonna let you explore that, but I just want to give you this quick method that all veteran players pretty much use to get GC seals, so then you're able to do it from the beginning. I hope you guys found this method helpful to get to GC farming right away. If you got any value again, make sure to hit that limit break 3 and subscribe down below. If you want to watch more Final Fantasy tutorials, then you can click here.